Hello, and welcome to the second episode of my channel. Today I am going to talk about a very interesting chemical called monobenzone. This chemical is the backbone of the depigmentation therapy for vitiligo, and people planning to go through that process must familiarize themselves with this chemical. Why? Because this chemical has the potential of affecting the rest of your life. If something has a potential of changing the rest of my life forever, I would like to know everything about it, and so should you. The reason I call this chemical a bit interesting is because until recently, no one knew how exactly it worked. Everyone knew that it removes the pigment from your skin, but no one was fully sure about how it achieves that purpose. It also had its fair share of controversies. For example, when police found the tubes of monobenzone at Michael Jackson's house after his death, it is also currently banned and restricted in some countries around the world. But it is a big topic. So I'm going to divide it into six smaller videos from episode 2.1 to 2.6. And through these videos, I will try not only to demystify this chemical, but also explain how to get it and how to use it properly to complete your depigmentation therapy. Let's have a quick look at the topics being discussed in the series. In the current episode, I will be discussing two main topics. What is monobenzone and how does it work to depigment your skin? So let's dive in. Welcome back. So what is monobenzone? Monobenzone is an organic chemical from the phenol family and is also known as monobenzyl ether of hydroquinone. It is used as a topical drug in medical depigmentation treatment for people who have extensive vitiligo and have no hope of being able to get their original color back. You can apply the cream on your skin where you still have the pigment, and it will help remove that pigment or color from that part of your skin and make it match the color of your vitiligo spots. This chemical also has some industrial uses and is used in rubber industry, and that industry it is known as 4-benzyloxyphenol. However, that's none of our interest, and we are more interested in the pharmaceutical part of it. So how does monobenzone work to depigment your natural colored skin and kill only the pigmented cells without destroying the healthy cells in our body? Since the accidental discovery of the drug in 1939, scientists have no definite model of how monobenzone works on a cellular level. All they know is that it depigments the skin, and it is possible to reproduce this effect in numerous trials. Although the research is still sparse on this subject, I will try my best to break down some new research into the drug and explain it in more easy to understand format. I will also leave a link to it in the description so you can have a read yourself. In 2012, a group of scientists conducted some deep research into monobenzone in order to find out about how it targets the cells that produce the skin pigment called melanocytes and destroy them permanently. They knew what it does, they just wanted to know how. This study actually focused to find a treatment for melanoma, the deadly skin cancer. And they were particularly curious about the mode of action of monobenzone. What they found out was quite interesting. It showed that monobenzone does not work alone to kill all the pigment. It has a partner in crime, and that partner is our own immune system. In simple layman terms, monobenzone reacts only to enzymes found in our pigment cells. This reaction creates metabolites that have a big toxic effect on the healthy cells. It also creates a lot of oxidative stress within the cells, resulting in free radicals, which further damages the cells. The accumulation of damage leads to a process called autophagy, when the cells press the self-destruct button on itself or eat itself. The debris from this breakdown is taken up by your immune system, which finds this behavior extremely suspicious and dispatches the soldier cell in our immune system called T cells to kill all the cells that resembles these debris, which in this case is melanocytes. This means that our own immune system not only kills the pigment cells where you apply the monobenzone, but across other parts of your body where you did not apply it. This is great news for people like us with extensive vitiligo, because this great teamwork of monobenzone and T cells allows us to achieve a general full body depigmentation effect without having to apply the cream on every nook and cranny of our body. I hope you like this video. Don't forget to check out the next video in this series. If you're new to my channel, do not forget to subscribe and share the videos to people who you think would be interested in this topic. Ciao.